Dr. A. Anthony Raj is an assistant professor in the Department of Physics at Loyola College, Chennai. He received his master degree and PhD from Loyola College affiliated to University of Madras. At present, he is working at Loyola College where he is teaching since 2016. His main research interests are in the areas of nonlinear optics, terahertz technology and synthesis of nanomaterials. He has published 10 papers in international and national journals. He has participated and presented many papers in international and national conferences.
Welcome to e-lecture on electronics practical. In this practical, we are going to design and construct low-pass RC filter and study its frequency response. The aim of the experiment is to design low-pass RC filter using resistor and capacitor and studying its frequency response. Components required are function generator, breadboard, cathode ray oscilloscope, resistors of value 10 kilo ohms, capacitance of value 0.01 microfarad. A filter is a type of circuit that passes a specified frequency and while rejecting all other frequencies. Filters can be generally classified into active filters and passive filters. Active filters are the filters that uses active components like operational amplifier and transistor. Passive filters uses passive element circuits like resistor, capacitor and inductors. In electronics, there are four basic types of filters are available. That is low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter and band stop filters. Low pass filter, it is designed to pass low frequency below the cutoff frequency while rejecting or attenuating all other frequency above the cutoff frequency. High pass filters is just opposite to the low pass filter. It allows all the frequency above the cutoff frequency while rejecting all other frequency below the cutoff frequency. In the case of band pass filter, it is the filter that passes all frequency within the band of frequencies and rejects all other frequency outside the band frequencies. For band stop filter, it rejects all other frequency within the band frequencies and passes all frequency outside the band frequencies. Now, low pass filter. Low pass filter can be a combination of resistor, capacitor or inductor. It is intended to produce high attenuations for a specified frequency and little or no attenuations for below that specified frequency. The frequency at which this transition takes place is called cutoff frequency or corner frequency. The cutoff frequency is defined as the frequency point where the capacitive reactance is equal to resistance, that is R is equal to XC. When this occurs, the output signal is attenuated to 70.7% of the input signal. Now, the value of the cutoff frequency can be calculated using the formula frequency cutoff is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. RC low pass filter. A simple RC low pass filter can be constructed using a resistor connected in series with a capacitor as shown in the figure. Now, this is the resistor of value 10 kilo ohm chosen and a capacitor in series of value 0.01 microfarad is selected for constructing a low pass RC filter. Now, the input signal from the function generator is applied in this position and the output is taken across the capacitor value of 0.01 microfarad. Now, let us see the working of this circuit. In this circuit, allows low frequency components and attenuates high frequency components in the input signal. That is, the capacitive reactance is calculated by formula XC is equal to 1 by omega C, where omega is nothing but 2 pi F, hence XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. That is, the capacitive reactance decreases with the increasing in frequencies. Now, in the figure, at high frequency value, the capacitor offers low reactance and thus act as a virtual short circuit, which directs the input signal amplitude to ground, thus the output falls to zero. At low frequency, the capacitor acts as an open circuit, that is, the capacitor offers high reactance and the entire signal appears at the output. Now, let us see the procedures. set up the circuit as shown in the figure. Then from the CRO, channel 1 is observed for input signal and channel 2 is connected for observing the output signal. Now from the function generator, I am going to set up the input voltage Vin to 4 volt, that is peak to peak voltage is chosen to 4 volt and frequency setup at 500 Hz. Calculating the cutoff frequency using the formula, F cutoff frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC, and this should be the frequency at which the output power is equal to 1 half of the input power, that is the voltage is equal to 0.707 times that of the input voltage. Using the measurement tool that is available in the CRO, we can calculate amplitude and frequency of the output signal. Record the data for 10 points, that is from 500 Hz to 10,000 Hz. And then calculating the cutoff frequency and comparing it. Use the graph to find the cutoff frequency. Here, a simple RC low pass filter is constructed by connecting a 10 kilo ohm resistance in series with 0.01 microfarad capacitance. Now, input signal is obtained from the functional generator, and the input signal is made to 4 volt peak to peak voltage at 500 Hz frequency. Now, in these cases, channel 1 is used for observing the input signal, and channel 2 is used for observing the output signal from the filter. Now, using the value of resistor and capacitor, the cutoff frequency value is found to be FC is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. By substituting the value of resistance and capacitance in these equations, the cutoff frequency is found to be 1600 Hz. Now, this low pass RC filter filters the frequency above 1600 Hz and it passes the frequency below 1600 Hz. Now, channel 1 is used for observing input signal, and channel 2 in the CRO is used for observing the output signal. In the function generator, the frequency is kept at constant. The input voltage is set to 4 volt peak to peak voltage at 500 Hz frequency. Now, using the measurement tools in the CRO, we can measure the amplitude of the output signal. Now, in these cases, this is the output signal and this is the input signal. Now, y-axis is used for obtaining the amplitude and thereby calculating the voltage, and along the x-axis, we can find the time period and thereby calculating the frequency. Now, in these cases, the input signal is actually having the value of peak-to-peak voltage, that is calculated by finding the amplitude equal to 2, and the voltage is multiplied here, the division is 2 multiplied with the voltage 2, that is 4 volt of peak to peak voltage is applied here. At low frequency, the output signal is also having the voltage of 4 volt. As I increase the frequency to 600 Hz, the output signal remains as similar to the input signal. As I further increase the frequency to 700 Hz, it remains as the same. Now, this output frequency or voltage remains until the cutoff frequency. As I increase the frequency to above 1600 Hz, the output signal starts attenuating. As the signal further increased to higher frequency, the output signal is actually completely attenuated, and hence RC low pass filter filters the frequency above the cutoff frequency, that is above 1600 Hz, the output signal starts attenuating and thereby rejecting all other frequency above the cutoff frequency. Now, the observation table can be made. input frequency is varied from 500 hertz to 10,000 hertz, and the corresponding output voltage can be calculated from the output signal from the channel 2. Now, in this diagram shows voltage against different value of input frequency, and thereby you can find the frequency response curve of low pass filter. In these cases, at low frequency below the cutoff frequency, the input signal is completely passed as output signal. As it approaches the cutoff frequency, then the output signal starts attenuating, and further increasing the frequency, input frequency, the output signal completely attenuated or rejected. Thus, a RC filter acts as a low pass filters. As the filter contains capacitor, a phase angle of the output signal lags behind the input. The phase angle pi can be calculated by arc tan of 2 pi FRC. And next, we shall see high pass RC filter. High pass RC filter is just exactly opposite to that of low pass RC filter. In low pass RC filter, the filter allows low frequency ranges, that is below the cutoff range frequency, is allowed to pass, and it rejects high frequency above the cutoff frequency. In the case of high pass filter, the frequency above cutoff range is allowed and the frequency below the cutoff range is attenuated. As we know that in the case of low pass filter, the frequency below the cutoff frequency is allowed while the frequencies above the cutoff frequency is rejected or attenuated. In the case of high pass filter, the filter allows the frequencies above the cutoff frequency while rejects the frequency below the cutoff frequencies. Now, we have constructed a simple high pass filter by connecting a capacitance in series with the resistance. This is the circuit diagram. A capacitor is connected in series with the resistor, and the output signal is taken across the resistor. Now, at low frequency region, the capacitor offers high reactance and it acts as a virtual short circuit, and thus it blocks all the input signal V in until it reaches the cutoff frequency. At high frequencies, the capacitor offers very low reactance and thereby acting as a short circuit and passes all the input signal to the output signal. The value of the cutoff frequency can be calculated by using the formula FC is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. And again, here by substituting the value of resistance and capacitance, the value of cutoff frequency is found to be 1600 hertz. That is, this high pass filter rejects the frequency below 1600 hertz and it allows the frequencies above 1600 hertz. As similar to the case of low pass frequency, in this high pass filter, the input signal is made to 4 volt peak to peak voltage at 500 hertz frequency. Now, channel 1 in the CRO is used for observing input signal, and channel 2 is used for observing the output signal. Now, in this case, this is the input signal and this is the output signal. High pass filter rejects all the low frequency region below the cutoff frequency. Now, if you look at this, the output signal is completely attenuated. As I increase the frequency, the value of the output signal increases, and further increasing the frequency from 500 hertz to 10,000 hertz, the capacitor offers very low reactance to the circuit and thereby making the circuit short circuited. It allows all the frequency to the output signal. As we further increase the input frequency, the capacitance offers very low reactance and thus acting as a short circuit passes all the input signal to the output signal. So this is the observation table where for the corresponding input frequency, the output voltage is calculated from the output signal. And this is the frequency response curve of high pass filter. In this curve, a gain is plotted with respect to frequency. At low frequency below the cutoff frequency, the signal is completely rejected or attenuated. As we increase the frequency, the capacitor offers very low reactance and thus acting as a short circuit and thereby passing the input signal completely to the output signal, and the output signal increases. Hence, above the cutoff frequency, all the frequencies are passes, and below the cutoff frequency, the frequencies are completely attenuated or rejected. And thus, high pass filter passes high frequency above the cutoff frequency and rejects all the frequency below the cutoff frequencies. With this, we come to an end of this practical. In this practical, we have seen construction and designing of low pass RC filter and construction and designing of high pass RC filters. Thank you.